So you are told that you have high blood pressure or hypertension. So you went to your primary care provider and you checked your blood pressure and you were told you have high blood pressure or your blood pressure is elevated. So what's next? What do you do from this point forward? Hello, I'm Dr. Rafai, the virtual nephrologist, and I want to share with you a few thoughts about what to do from this point forwards. First and foremost, what you need to realize that this is an isolated reading at the healthcare provider's office. This is not the diagnosis of hypertension. You need to be checking your blood pressure readings at home, and you need to determine whether you have elevated blood pressure at home and not only at your provider's office. And the way to do this, you'd have to do it for a period of 2 weeks, and you do it twice a day, once in the morning and once in the evening. And every time you do it, you take two readings and you take the pulse with that as well. So you do it twice a day, two times in the morning, 5 minutes apart, two times in the evening, 5 minutes apart, and you also check your pulse. And keep in mind, if this reading is not accurate, at the doctor's office and the doctor starts you on a blood pressure medicine and you're actually your blood pressure is normal at home, the next thing, your blood pressure is going to be very low. You're going to pass out. You're going to feel dizzy and weak. Or if your blood pressure is normal at the doctor's office, but actually it is elevated at home, then there is a missing chance that you may be having serious blood pressure that is going untreated. You check your blood pressure readings for a period of 2 weeks, twice a day, twice in the morning, 5 minutes apart, twice in the evening, 5 minutes apart, with also checking your pulse. But before you check your blood pressure, you have to know, and I put these instructions down in the comments with a link to the guidelines, you have to know how to check your blood pressure. First thing you do is you have to be seated and comfortable for 5 minutes in your seat. You have to have had the last heavy meals 2 hours ago, and you have to have any caffeinated drinks or exercise, or if you smoke a cigarette, you have to have the last cigarette smoked 30 minutes before. So you sit, you get comfortable, you put your arm on a table, and you have your elbow at the level of your heart. You put an appropriate size cuff on your arm, wraps around your upper arm, not on your wrist. Wrist monitors are not very accurate. You put your blood pressure cuff right up here, and you have to be relaxed. Your feet are on the floor. Do not cross your legs. And then you sit and you get comfortable and you measure your blood pressure. Those are accurate readings. And you do it 5 minutes apart, twice a day, with your pulse, and you record them. And then you go to your healthcare provider and say, here are my readings. Do I have blood pressure or not? So don't depend on one reading to label and stamp yourself with a diagnosis of high blood pressure or a normal blood pressure. Do it frequently, do it twice a week, three times a week, and if you are on the edge of having the diagnosis, you have to do it twice a day for 2 weeks. I hope I made it very clear that it is not a one-time reading, it is a two-week reading, twice a day, twice in the morning, 5 minutes apart, twice in the evening, 5 minutes apart, with the pulse as well checked, and take it to your provider and then make a decision whether you have high blood pressure or not. I wish you great health. I wish you a healthy blood pressure. Stay healthy and stay safe. This is the virtual nephrologist. I am Dr. Rafai.
To learn more about kidney disease, visit us on the web at thevirtualnephrologist.com.